Bonjour and welcome to Rammstein Reacts at PopCulture Reacts as we are enjoying Frühling in Paris.
I noticed a slight fluctuation there. I'm guessing that was, is that just because it's got Paris in the title, or is there more to it than that?
It's just because it's got Paris in the title and showing a little bit of European love.
Yeah, I mean, my French is stronger than my German purely because I did French at school, but my French is pretty pish as well. I can ask for a ham sandwich and I'm a vegetarian, so I really need to extend out my ability to speak French.
I dropped French after a year and just did German for 4 years because I got German better. French, and it's weird having, you know, male and female versions of the same thing.
I didn't have a choice until 3 years in, and at that point I just thought, oh god, like, I've done 3 years of French at this point, I'm not dumping that and starting something else. But then by the time it came to doing exams, I got to the point where my attitude was, I'm just gonna dump and not go to them because I don't care. which is not so much like my feeling on it necessary as a language, but I didn't care about a lot of my subjects at school at that point, and I only really attended for the ones that I thought I might utilise.
The mandatory ones.
Well, that, you know, like I liked English, but I liked English because of the literature side of it. I actually liked maths, and I could see a functional reason for it. Outside of that, I was pretty much, yeah, I ain't going to use most of this stuff. I could spend my time learning other things.
What do you mean? You've not found a use for that GCSE in chemistry?
But I didn't do chemistry, mate. Binned it. Didn't turn up. Binned it. Went for biology and physics. Physics is like maths. Biology seemed easier.
See, did chemistry because I could blow shit up.
Yeah, actually, that's a good point. Should have probably done chemistry for that. But again, I wouldn't have turned up for lessons, so it wouldn't have mattered anyway.
So enough about our school days.
Yes, or our non-school days by my confessions. But
have you ever had a springtime in Paris?
Oh, I've been to Paris. I can't remember if it's springtime or not. It probably was. It was either spring or summer. So I'm going to go with yes, I have had a springtime in Paris. Yourself?
No, I had a summer. We went at the back end of a school year, so it was during the summer, but never had a springtime in Paris.
See, mine was post-school years. Mine was a holiday with my other half at the time. What did we think of Paris, Chris?
I wasn't a massive fan of Paris. I preferred Nice. I preferred Romani. And there was much nicer parts of France than Paris.
Outside of some places I've had to go to in the UK, more for work than holidays, Paris is the least favourite place I've ever been to. Now, I will say that, don't take that as a damning indictment of Paris, because I haven't been to hundreds and hundreds of places, but it's the one that I guess I was let down the most by, and I think, unfortunately for me, the biggest letdown for me is I think it had just been oversold. It was sold as almost a magical place, and I think when you went to the more touristy areas, you could see a bit of effort had gone in, and you went anywhere else and there was people lunatically driving their cars into each other, dog shit and litter everywhere else, and it kind of lost its romance at that point for me.
But shall we see what Rammstein think of a springtime in Paris?
I hope dog shit and car crashes are in this song, so it's not just my experience of it. Right, let's go.
Ist es noch wie heute? Ich war so jung, hab mich geniert. doch hab es nie bereut. Sie rief mir Worte ins Gesicht, die Zunge Lust gestreut. Verstand nur ihre Sprache nicht, ich hab es nicht bereut. Oh no.
We've talked a bit in the last couple of tracks about some musical departures from previous works. This is the biggest one for me for this album so far. I liked it a lot, but for me, I was listening to musically. I was listening to a British indie band, and not Rammstein. That really threw me. I don't really know where to go musically other than that. I'm going, I can't believe it's them. And not that they don't have the ability to do that, but I just, I, never would have expected them to produce a song like that.
With the slightly jangly guitar, is that, was it the
everything about it, like the tone? I mean, like, I'm just smacked to me of bands like the Manic Street Preachers and what they were doing, like, and yeah, I wasn't expecting that out of Rammstein. I mean, I guess we got a teensy bit of that when we had the song with Charlene Spiteri, where we said that we felt that the lean was a bit into, for me certainly, it was a bit too far into Texas style music, and I liked it to get more Rammstein. But yeah, I love that musically. And again, I'm quite taken aback because I could have, if you played me that without the lyrics, without the vocals, and you gave me 1,000 guesses, I wouldn't have guessed Rammstein. Probably give me 10,000 guesses, I wouldn't guess Rammstein.
The thing I like about this is how it builds, and yeah, you've got that sort of soft, as you say, non-Rammstein-y sort of beginning, but I just, yeah, if you go with what the lyrics are, is obviously I'm guessing a loss of virginity sort of vibe going on, and like the triumphantness.
Like there's a lot of imagery, if that isn't there.
Yeah, and obviously where it goes musically, and that sort of triumph and the horns and stuff. That sort of, you know, that I've done it. Sort of huzzah vibe and feel that's coming out of it. I really like this as sort of, you know, the beginning bit being quite a nervousy, slightly insular, the kiss of the skin. Ooh. But then at the end it's like, I've done it in Paris.
I went with the music being quite UK indie. It's only just plopped into my head. Drums felt very New York indie to me. Very kind of... that New York music scene that ultimately eventually birthed bands like the Yeah Yeah Yeahs and things like that, and what they do with their drums sounds very kind of in that wheelhouse. But yeah, very indie. Lyrically, I think you're right. I think there's I don't know. I think there's, like so many of their songs, I think there's multi interpretations of this one, and I think they kind of all work. And I think there's a lot, as you say, around that. That concept of losing one's virginity. I think there's also a lot. I was kind of getting a lot about, and I know the literal like Paris being in the title, but almost conceptually this idea of Paris being a temptress, trying to tempt people into that to kind of want to be there, but ultimately no, it wasn't. It wasn't tempting enough for let's go with the band, because it wasn't ultimately for them as tempting as it may be. And but yeah, I think there's a lot to dig in on this one. Very good again, very very good again. Despite it rocking me a little bit at first, I think this is one that I'm going to come back to a lot. I think.
So, as always, what do you got out there? Take from this, think of this, how'd you read the lyrics and how it is musically in the comments, as always. Like, subscribe, ring the bell.
And sorry, I loved the bit in French, the Edith Piaf. I can't do it. The Jean
de Gretien.
Yeah, lovely kind of tip the hat to a beautifully sung, well-renowned song. Loved that bit in there. Sorry, I meant to say that as the first thing, but I forgot it. But yeah, really, really like that.
So as always, like, subscribe, ring the bell. We'll be back with Weiner Blunt. And until then...
What does it mean? You can't leave it mean? Me hanging like that. What does it mean?
Viennese blood.
Ah, is that like a black pudding in the UK?
that, or they've taken a Viennese whirl.
Oh, I like a Viennese whirl.
And changed the cream inside to blood.
Like it a bit less now. You've kind of put me off it a little bit. But...
Or is it jam coming out of it?
Yeah. I want a Viennese whirl now. I'm going to have to run up the shop. So
Always. Every time we do a recording, you end up having to go to the shop for something we mentioned.
I do like a shop run. For those who want to know what happens behind the curtain, generally when we record, we sit down and we do whatever videos we've kind of got planned to do. So often there'll be like a kind of mini break in the middle for a cigarette and a refill of the cup of tea. But yeah, they tend to always end with like, we need to wrap this up in a minute, mate, because the shop's closing at 11, that sort of thing, because I want to go and buy something to eat.
Because we've mentioned something and it's then gone, oh, I want that.
Or the horrors of doing this on YouTube. YouTube will chuck an advert on that we tend to try and avoid you from having to see, depending on how much editing I can be bothered to do. And it'll be something food related. I'll be like, yeah, I want one of them now.
So until next time, and he gets his Viennese Wells.
Hopefully.
Goodbye.